good morning. As you can tell from my breath, yes, we're in the tropical paradise that is Rugeley. It's so warm here, it's unbelievable. It's not, it's fucking freezing. It's absolutely freezing cold. Every breath I'm taking, it looks like I'm bloody... What clags a lot? What likes to clag a lot? A Deltic. There you go. Behind me, Utter Beast, 175.10. She'll be soon departing on her way back to Birmingham. And is a two-day video diary for this one. Our first day takes us down some stations to Warrington Bank Quay, called the Eccles, Patricroft, Newton-le-Willows on the way back. Earlstown, Warrington Bank Quay, back to Earlstown for another hour, and then Newton-le-Willows for finish. And then tomorrow is all the suburban stations between Manchester, Piccadilly and Stoke-on-Trent, non-inclusive. Manchester, Piccadilly and Macclesfield, non-inclusive Piccadilly, but that's tomorrow. So, we're just waiting for him to depart, we're waiting for the 7:41, and we'll soon be off to Manchester and then on to Warrington. Here comes 53.73.
This. Oh, not this again.
Yes, this one again, Simon.
Oh, it's only yesterday.
This is the heavy delayed 7:43 to crew.
Trent Valley Stoke is busy.
Here at Manchester Piccadilly. Formation as well. No, it's nice in right formation.
Eccles, if you're leaving the train here at Eccles, please take all your personal belongings and hand luggage with you. Please take care when leaving the train and mind the step between the train and the platform.
No, I've not got on a unit that is this up. A diesel unit is this size, it wants to be like this. I'm actually on a 319 here. 319-368 has brought us to our first station, Eccles.
Okay. Have you stopped filming?
No.
I don't think you're filming.
I am.
Oh.
Here we are, Eccles.
chill and...
This is Patra Croft. Would you mind, sir? Thank you very much. Station number 3A of the day, Earlstown. Can't see.
for the 13:22 Northern service to Warrington Bank Quay, calling at Warrington Bank Quay only.
Approaching Warrington Bank Quay.
Okay.
in style. On the second wag, 18307, being pushed by 67001.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This train calls at Earlstown and Manchester Piccadilly. Any passengers for Newton-le-Willows, please change at Earlstown. Any passengers for Manchester Oxford Road, please remain with us to Manchester Piccadilly and change there. The next stop in about 6 minutes will be Earlstown. If you're leaving the train at Earlstown, please take care. As the platform is on a curve, there is a gap between the train and the platform edge.
Just on Market Street now.
Because I'm pretty tired and I am just about ready to go to bed. I will say if you do hear some incandescent banging, it seems that we've got some kids up above us in our room, and they want to treat 11 p.m. at night as playtime. All I say to that is get to sleep, you little rotters. So yes, five stations in all today. We started off by doing Eccles, which weren't bad at all. Usually used to doing the other side, but we got them all on the Sub-Run. Then we went to Patchcroft, where we got 44871. Been a while since I saw 44871 on the main line. She sounded in good health, so yeah, that was a good shout. Then we did Earlstown. Now, we did Earlstown in two parts, basically because, for those who don't know Earlstown, Earlstown's on a triangle, so it's a tri-platform station, and it did look like it was going to get really complicated at one point, but we managed to plough our way through it, so we got Earlstown out of the way in two parts. Then we put Warrington Bank Key in, hoping to walk away with loads of very short-term plans, and in the end, they were very short-termly put off. The only thing of note really is that I walked away finally with 90040, which has since returned to traffic after a long period out. Oh, and the WAG. We rode on the secondary WAG to Earlstown, so we can get the second hour done there. Surprisingly though, that WAG's all standard. No first class in there. Which does shock me. And then after the second round at Earlstown, we did Newton-le-Willows. And that all went according to plan. So, yeah. We are ready to shut the fuck up. Honestly, you're worse than my brother back home. So yeah, we're ready to go to bed now. So tomorrow we're going to head back to Rouge Lane. We're going to take the slow traffic back to Stoke-on-Trent before we head onwards. Eight stations in total tomorrow, all Northern Rail suburban stations, and yeah, that'll be tomorrow all sorted, so we'll see you for that tomorrow. I'm just about to head off to bed now because I'm pretty tired.
Good. Which way are we going? That way. Oh, there we go.
Please allow there to be light. More normal. Would you be so kind as to get the door for me, sir?
Fine.
Thank you, sir. I'll start singing. We got there early enough. Here comes our tram to Piccadilly. Got himself a double stacker. £5 says this is empty. Give you £5. Well, we've got 30.75 lead in the train. See, I told you it was empty. And on the rear, 30.98. Which is even emptier. Alright, and you're going to the back. Yeah, I want a photo of this one too. You've hit the button already, Si. Because now look, that's activated to say, oh yes, please let me out. Just leaving Picker. Should be leaving the station any moment now. First stop, Leventune.
It's now approaching our first station, Leventune.
Here we are.
bit of a downturn, unfortunately. As you can see, we are here at Heaton Chapel. And unfortunately, it looks like the day on this stretch has come to an end. What has happened is at Prestbury, which is one of the stations we were doing.
We think it's Prestbury.
We think it's Prestbury. Twitter and real time are saying Prestbury. I imagine National Rail will say Prestbury as well. All we know is it's between Cheadlehume and Macclesfield.
Just delayed.
Yeah, just that was basically our train. There is some form of blockage on the line at Prestbury. So what we are going to...
But they do say one under.
Yeah, we're hearing one under. So if it is one under, thoughts to all involved, etc, etc, etc. What we are going to do is we're actually going to do a U-turn, go back to Manchester and explore options that way. Because that line, if it is a one under, it's going to be blocked for a while. So we'll go back that way, we'll see what happens, and we may go back that way, we may not, but we don't know. So bear with us on this one, please. Just bear with us. Simon's going to be happy. Here comes the 1022 Southport. .142003 leading.
Oh.
Hotel, now approaching Manchester Oxford Road. Simon's gonna do it. Ooh, look, Simon's getting comfortable with a pacer bus. Next time you open the door with a pacer bus, use all your fingers. You filthy knacker.
I'm guessing the vehicle's gonna use that side.
Yes.
Nope.
Try again.
Nope.
Now try. Thank you. gate. Manchester Deans gate. Deans gate, Castlefield.
Yes.
Sign will be the first to know what conditions are like out here.
Yeah. We'll put a portal down to the entrance.
Any rubbish, please? Thank you.
Next stop will be Stoke-on-Trent.
Yeah, just getting ready to pull into the SOT. Yeah, that don't work with these trains, though. That don't work with these trains. You know better. Nice and cool here. Otherwise we're in trouble. This could be 351.12.
Show you the progress made on what will be the flyover, which will effectively kill off the North Bridge. Flyover should be completed by 2018?
So it's too late.
2017-2018. Enable all the trains that used to have to cross these lines to get over to Norton Bridge to just take the slow road over it. Ah, here comes the flyover. You can see they've started to put the stanchions in. For the electric wires. I believe when this is done, it will enable probably
your son. Maybe two tracks.
And a tamper. When this is done, it'll hopefully enable the Stoke Manchester local to extend, maybe.
Yeah, what? Sorry, that guy that is.
Alright.
what we're doing then.
That way, train.
You want to wait for that train?
Yeah.
Welcome home.
Right then, we are on 17510, the former Uber Beast, but has now since been looted. We've fixed the turbos, so it now clags properly and not clags like it used to clag. Shortened down day today, unfortunately, mainly due to the fatality at Crestbury. What I think's happened, please, this is only speculation, what I think's happened, because when we crawled past Crestbury on the Pendo Down, there was a big hole missing from the wall, which had been fenced off with, you know, those little plastic fences that you sometimes see for crowd control. What I think's happened is, because there's a road next door, a car or a vehicle of some description went through that fence onto the tracks, and somehow one H14 got involved. So, again, that's only speculation. I'm not saying that because I know it's fact, I'm only guessing. It's meant as no harm, and it should be taken as no harm. It did spoil the day, but that's the way life goes. We ended up going to Ockey Road and Deansgate instead of doing all the stations down from Cheadlehume through to Congleton. The only flip side of it was we got 158889, the transferee from South West Trains through to East Midlands Trains. Not much of a transfer, it's only had a name change.
South to East.
South to East, yeah. So, yeah, that's going to be the end of the video diary. I appreciate it's a shortened down day, but it is what it is. There's still getting you back on track with the timetable, so it's pointless staying around and doing anything. So, that being said, we're just going to wait for the 15:41 to depart. Then we're going to go back home. So, you know, all the usual channels to subscribe to. And I'd like to thank you all very much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed watching it as much as I've enjoyed doing it. The next one, I'm not sure. If it's not the Cross City Line that we do on Saturday, which we're keeping an eye on for the weather, it will definitely be my most ambitious overnighter yet. Which it was going to be very ambitious, trust me. But yeah, that's all for this episode. I shall see you all on the next video diary, whenever that be. And thank you all very much for watching.